Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on common causes and diagnostics for a vehicle making clunking sounds while turning. Just as a quick note before we jump into the bulk of this video, just want to point out that there are quite a few different sounds that may come while you're turning the vehicle and different ways to describe those sounds. So we're referring to it as clunking mostly, but it could be clunking, screeching, knocking, rattling, whining, or a number of different ways to describe the specific sound that is affecting your vehicle while you're turning. But ultimately, while we move throughout the video, we will try to specify which issues make certain sounds and how to better diagnose the issues using those sounds and finding the underlying problem at hand. When it comes to a vehicle making clunking, whining, rattling, knocking sounds while turning, it's usually related to something with the suspension or steering system or the wheels and tires on the vehicle. So those are going to be the most common causes, but there are a lot of various components with the steering and suspension system. So throughout this video, we'll break down a few of those most common causes of weird sounds while you're turning your vehicle, and as well as walk through some diagnostics towards the end of the video to actually identify the problem that is causing your weird sounds while you're turning your vehicle. Jumping into things right off the bat, at number one on the list, we have tie rods. Tie rods are a vital part of the vehicle's steering and suspension system. They connect the steering rack to the steering knuckles, and without tie rods, it would be impossible to turn or handle or maneuver your vehicle. So it's a very important part of vehicle steering and operation. Usually when you have bad tie rods, what it'll result in is a knocking or clunking sound while turning the vehicle. And that's especially true and typically more noticeable at lower speeds. So you might not notice the knocking or clunking sounds as much at higher speeds in general, but at low speeds, that knocking and clunking is typically very loud and easy to notice if you do have any tie rod issues. Some other symptoms to look out for that could point to problems with the tie rods would be vibration through the steering wheel or just loose feeling steering in general, as well as uneven tire wear and bad front end alignment. Now, those symptoms can also be symptoms of other issues that we'll be discussing throughout this video. So if you have those symptoms along with knocking and clunking, it doesn't mean it's definitely the tie rods. However, tie rods are among one of the more common issues that does cause a knocking or clunking sound while you're turning your vehicle. Moving on to number two, we have the sway bar links, which are also known as anti-roll bars. Sway bars or anti-roll bars do exactly as the name suggests. They prevent the vehicle from excessively swaying or rolling while you take a corner. So very important to handling and overall stability of your vehicle. With the sway bar end links, it's typically the bushings within those end links that wear down and cause issues with the sway bars. So if you are having issues with the sway bar end links and that is a cause of the problem, you might notice some additional symptoms outside of clunking and rattling sounds that can happen at any speeds. Might also notice that the car has increased body roll. So if your vehicle feels like it's excessively swaying or rolling, that could indicate an issue with the sway bars. Additionally, you'll notice uneven tire wear and typically that the outer edge of the tire is wearing down faster than the inside of the tire, and that is because as the sway bars are on their way out or not working properly, the vehicle will roll more, which puts excess weight on the outer portion of the tire while you're cornering. So that's why the outside will wear down quicker than the inside of the tire with sway bar end link problems. Moving on to number three on the list, we have issues with the ball joints that can also cause knocking and clunking sounds while turning your vehicle. A suspension ball joint is simply a ball and socket that allows for the pivoting movement between the steering knuckles and the control arms. So very important to have that ball and socket to allow the movement, that pivoting motion between the control arms and steering knuckle. Again, as with pretty much all of these components that can make weird sounds while you're turning your vehicle, ball joints are a vital part of your vehicle's suspension system. So any ball joint issues are something that should be addressed as soon as possible. Knocking or clunking sounds are the most common sounds when the ball joints are on their way out and having issues. However, you might also notice loose feeling steering as well as wandering steering or handling, vibrations through the steering wheel, and then uneven tire wear as with the other two problems that we just discussed. Pretty similar symptoms and sounds between the sway bar end links, the tie rods, and the ball joints. If you are hearing a knocking or a clunking sound specifically, those are certainly three of the most common causes Now, there are a lot of various other components in the suspension and steering system that can also cause similar sounds and symptoms. Moving on to problem number four, we're just talking about suspension and steering system in general here. These systems involve a lot of different components and a lot of various bushings, joints, and a lot of components in general. You have the trailing arms, trailing arm bushings, control arms, all of the bushings involved in that, as well as numerous other suspension components. Ultimately, any one of these issues, especially if you have a worn down ball joint or a worn down bushing somewhere, can cause these similar knocking and rattling or clunking noises, as well as things like uneven tire wear, vibrations, or loose. So again, it can be tough to diagnose specifically what it is, but as we move through in the first three issues, the tie rod, sway bar end links, especially the bushings within the sway bar end links, as well as the suspension ball joints, are going to be the three most common causes. But again, just wanted to point out with number four here, a little bit broader of a list of issues that can cause similar symptoms. So again, can be a little challenging to diagnose, but we'll circle back to that at the end of the video to help give a little bit of guidance on where to start looking if you are running into these knocking and clunking sounds while turning your vehicle. Moving on to our fifth common cause of a vehicle making weird noises while turning is the power steering system. So this could be as simple as something like low power steering fluid. When the power steering fluid is low and you start turning the wheel on your vehicle, you might notice a loud, obnoxious whining sound coming from the front end by the power steering system and the steering rack. So if you have a whining sound while you're turning your vehicle, that's one of the first things to do. Just check that power steering fluid. If the levels are low, it could be as simple as just topping up the fluid. That should solve the issues with the whining. Of course, if you do have low power steering fluid, it's possible that you have a leak or an issue somewhere else that needs to be addressed. So just be on the lookout for any leaking fluid if you are low on it. However, it isn't abnormal to lose a little bit of power steering fluid over the lifetime of the vehicle or since the power steering fluid was last changed or topped off. So it could just be a little bit of natural fluid loss that is causing that issue. If you are hearing a whining sound and the power steering fluid seems to be topped off and has the appropriate level, then it could be a failing power steering pump, which generally shows the same symptoms as low power steering fluid, which is simply a whining noise while turning your vehicle. Otherwise, two other things to address with the steering system and power steering system would be the actual steering rack itself, along with the universal joints. If either of those are having issues, then you'll typically notice knocking or clunking sounds similar to a number of the issues that we addressed earlier in this video. But of course, again, these involving the steering rack will come from the driver's side of the vehicle right around that steering column. So that should help kind of point you in the right direction if that knocking and clunking sound is coming from there. Check your steering rack and check the universal joints, since those could be issues that are also causing that knocking or clunking sound. Moving on to issue number six on our list here, we mentioned the rest of the suspension components and suspension system. One thing that we hadn't discussed yet was shocks and struts. So at number six here, we have shocks and struts as a common cause of vehicles making knocking or clunking or other weird sounds while turning. Shock absorbers or struts are normal wear and tear components. On most vehicles, they should be replaced roughly every 8 to 12 years, or about 80,000 to 120,000 miles. Now, that range does vary widely depending on your specific year, make, and model of vehicle. Typically, performance cars tend to need suspension replacement and refreshes a little more frequently, whereas typical less performance-oriented cars or SUVs tend to get a little bit more life out of those suspension components. These are wear and tear parts that require replacement likely at some point during the lifetime of the vehicle. So if you know your shocks or struts are old and you're hearing a knocking or clunking sound while driving and turning your vehicle, then it very well could be bad shock absorbers or struts. When they are on their way out, one common sign or symptom would be fluid on the outside of the shock or strut. They do use fluid. Over time, they can begin leaking, and that will leave fluid stains on the shock absorber or the strut. So if you're noticing that, chances are that you have a bad component there. Some other symptoms of faulty and old worn shocks and struts include a bouncy ride. You might notice that the car feels like it's nosediving a little bit more if you hit the brakes hard, or squatting in the rear if you accelerate quickly. You might also notice excess sway or rolling while you're cornering, as well as a number of other symptoms that are possible with worn out suspension or shocks and struts. Ultimately, where the knocking and clunking sound tends to come from is as those shocks or struts wear down, they start bottoming out on the bump stops, which will create that knocking or clunking sound. And this can happen when you're cornering and the vehicle rolls enough that suspension bottoms out on the bump stop. And it can be especially noticeable if you hit a bump or a big pothole, and that causes suspension to bottom out, and you'll notice a very harsh impact along with that knocking or clunking sound when it bottoms out. Last but not least on the list here at number 7 for common causes of a vehicle making clunking, knocking, or other weird noises while turning are the wheels and tires. So this is a pretty broad topic. There are a number of various things with the wheels and tires that could cause knocking, clunking, rattling, or other noises. Fortunately, wheels and tires are easy to inspect, and any issues with them would likely be very easy to notice just with a quick, easy visual inspection. A couple things to look out for if you are hearing this sound with the wheels and tires. Sometimes maybe you have a loose bumper or a loose fender liner that's just sagging down, and when you turn your vehicle, the wheels and tires are coming into contact with whatever component is loose, again, something like a bumper or a fender liner. Maybe you lowered your vehicle and it's now too low. When you corner, the wheels are rubbing on the fender liner, so you might need to roll your fenders or look into alternative options or different wheel fitments. And then another thing to be on the lookout for, just make sure you have all of your lug nuts on the vehicle and that they are properly and securely tightened and bolted down to the wheels. Usually lug nuts don't just disappear or fall out on their own. However, if you did recently work on the vehicle or someone else recently worked on the vehicle and the wheels were off, maybe they didn't tighten the lug nuts all the way back down properly, or occasionally you can just lose lug nuts over time if they haven't been touched or tightened in a while. So just make sure you have all of your lug nuts in place and that nothing's obviously out of place and interfering with the wheel and tire and potentially bumping into it. Ultimately, a few different things that can cause the wheels and tires to make weird sounds while you're turning your vehicle, but fortunately, it's all pretty simple stuff that you can notice with a quick visual inspection. Circling back to diagnostics, when it comes to diagnosing these problems, it can be tough since a lot of these steering and suspension components are in similar areas. And when you hear that knocking or clunking sound, you might be able to identify that it's coming from the front or the rear of the vehicle, but it might be hard to pinpoint exactly in a certain area, whether it be coming from a control arm or a tie rod or a sway bar bushing. But the area of the vehicle the sound is coming from is very important. Obviously, if you're hearing something at the rear of the vehicle, then it likely doesn't have anything to do with the power steering system or the steering column or rack. So you can likely eliminate that if the noise is coming from the rear. Same thing if it's coming from the passenger side of the vehicle, then it's not likely the universal joints or anything to do with the steering column. Step one for diagnostics is really doing your best, trying to figure out specifically where that noise is coming from and which of the four corners of the vehicle that noise is coming from. That should at least get you started and point you in the right direction. You can then eliminate a number of problems, again, like the steering rack example, if it's in the rear of the vehicle or the passenger side of the vehicle, or you might want to look further into the steering rack and steering column if you notice the sound is coming from right in front of the steering wheel and right in front of the driver's seat. So knowing where that location is very important, and also distinguishing the exact sound that you're hearing. If it's something like a whining sound, then it's likely the power steering fluid or power steering pump. Whereas if you're hearing more of a knocking or clunking sound, it likely indicates your suspension's worn down or you have a bushing or a ball joint somewhere in the vehicle that is worn down. Otherwise, once you know what the sound is, where it's coming from, start with the basics, see if anything's obviously out of place, if anything's disconnected, or again, something like a fender liner or a bumper is loose and impacting the tire. So start with those basics. From there, it can be challenging just since so many of these parts are in a similar area. So if nothing obvious is out of place, it'll be time for slightly deeper diagnostics, which will involve taking some things apart and inspecting and looking at various bushings. Maybe try moving things around, see if something like the sway bar or control arms have excess play. And if that doesn't show anything, then your best bet might be just to head to a qualified mechanic and have them diagnose the issue rather than throwing money at various things and various parts that may or may not be the ultimate cause of the knocking or clunking sounds while turning your vehicle. That wraps up our video for today, guys. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks, guys.